VIPtv, down at Jennings Gym, with the English Cruiserweight Champion, Matty Askin. Matty, how you doing, mate?
Oh, fantastic, mate. Yourself?
Nice little session there with you.
Yeah, just a nice steady one today.
Oh, doesn't look like it. I enjoyed watching that there, a little bit of a technical pad session with Mike.
Yeah, it was good, you know, just learning on new things. Well, not really learning on new things, just brushing up on the things that we've already learned.
Yeah.
And getting ready to put them into action on a week on Saturday.
Do we know your opponent, mate?
Yuri Svenichka, is it?
I'm glad you're trying that one, mate.
He's from Czech Republic. He's on the distance with a few up-and-comers. Fought Enzo McAnally in his last fight. Give him a tough fight, it seems. Well, I think McAnally breezed it, but it took him a while to get him out of there.
It's all a bit awkward, I've been told.
Yeah, very awkward style. Leans back, throwing jabs from awkward angles and stuff like that. It's just, he's going to give me something to think about on the night.
And what's this going to be over then, Matt? Is it 10 rounds or 8 rounds?
8 rounds.
Yeah. 8 rounds. And, like, we've got to talk about it. Your last fight out when you went down to London.
Yeah.
With Lawrence Bennett.
Bit of a farce, wasn't it?
He's not been reprimanded or anything, has he?
No, nothing's been done with it. It only seems to be professionals and people inside the sport that have realised what he's done. He clearly doesn't think he's done anything wrong, but when you see it, you know, he has threw me out of the ring, he's rugby tackled me out of the ring, and he had a chance to get off me.
Yeah.
And still didn't, and pushed off
and
the
landed
side
on
of the
you
ring.
As well from about 4 foot.
Yeah, elbowing me while we're on the floor and all sorts. Guy's just an absolute tool.
Mm.
It's just all I can say about it.
Well, I watched an interview with iFi, and you were angry before that fight, so I'm dreading what's going to happen in. When is this going to be rescheduled for? March, February?
February, March next year, yeah. It goes to purse bids on the 9th, and then we'll figure out then what dates are going to be set. We've offered him the fight twice for December 12th. He bottled it. Said he feared for his safety down in Blackpool. And then Warren's put an offer into him, and he's refused that as well. So, you know, he's a short kind of guy. He's a shitbag.
So, don't hold back.
No, I'll go back down and smash his fucking head in when the date gets set.
So we've got December the 6th, Winter Gardens, Blackpool.
Yeah.
And hopefully that's going to set up this rematch with Lawrence Bennett for next year.
This should keep me active, you know. Keep me busy.
Well, that was the problem last time, wasn't it? When you got your break against Auburn with Quincy, almost 12 months out to the day, wasn't it?
Yeah, well, 13 months, so I think it works out as.
Yeah.
You know, it did affect me come fight night, but I didn't think it did. Just with the fact, in the last stretch, you know, I kind of lost my composure a bit and left it to the judges' scorecards a little bit too close.
Mm-hmm.
But now, you know, I've kept active since the fight. Well, this will be my fourth fight since McKenzie, or fourth fight including McKenzie's, which will be the busiest I've been, and that's down with Mike and Steve Woods as well, putting on his shows.
Well, listen, good luck. Hopefully next year could be a big year, because you can defend your title and hopefully go on to bigger and better things, mate.
Certainly will, thanks, Lee.
Matty, take care.
See you, mate.
Bye-bye. Bye.